Hey guys, so I have part one of my Sephora haul, and this is like literally the biggest Sephora package to ever come to my house. So let's open it. There's like a lot of filling in here. Literally look how much paper. Here's some of the stuff I got. It doesn't seem that much, but it's just because of this. Okay, starting off with the smaller products. First thing I got was this Patrick Ta sort of contour brush. Okay, I'm opening it up. I don't think I own a Patrick Ta brush before, but this one looked like really good quality, so I had to buy it. But here's what it looks like. So it has like a smaller side and a rounder side, and oh my god, this feels amazing. It's really pretty and it looks like amazing quality, so I'm very excited to be using this. Okay, next we have this Refi brow tip, and this is like the circular tip, and I don't think I got the right color, I'm gonna be real, but I kind of want to try it on like right now. Okay. Yeah, I think it's too light, but I don't know. Did that make a difference? Okay, comment if you saw a difference, but I'm a little underwhelmed. Anyways. Okay, so next I got a refill of this serum, so I don't need to open it because I don't need to use it yet. And then I got this Tower 28 gloss in the shade Coconut, which I want to try right now. I'm trying to rush so I can fit everything, but this shade looks so pretty. Very pretty pinky shade in. Smells a little like coconut. It's very faint, which I like. You guys know that I don't like strong smelling products, but that's so pretty. Okay, next I got this Merit Great Skin Instant Glow Serum, which I'll probably use in my like get ready with me's. This packaging is gorgeous and I love everything from Merit, and this looks like amazing. Okay, I'm just gonna like try a bit. Oh wow, it's very glossy and shiny. I need that. And I love how like easily it closes, like you can tell. And next, I got this Makeup by Mario Moisture Glow Lip Plumping Serum, shade Rose Gold, and I don't have this shade yet, guys. Anyways, let me do like a little swatch right here. That's so pretty. Okay, finally, we have the Shark Flex Style thing, which is like, I've been calling it a Dyson dupe, but I heard it works better. Okay, I'm like trying to open this up. Shake, come on. Okay, so when you take this off, it comes with all the parts here. I wish it came with a container, though. So we have some instructions. We have like the main sort of thing where you attach the things on. Then we have 5 attachments. So here's like the regular blow drying one. We've got like a really round brush. I think this is like the flyaway brush thingy. Then we have like the 2 roller thingies, which I'm really excited to use. I've tried the Dyson before. I thought it was really hard to use at first. It's definitely something you need to get used to. But I think that since I've used that before, this will be easier for me to use. But here's what it looks like. And I think this was $299 without like the sale discount. But yeah, I'll give you guys an update. But yeah, bye. Let me know if you enjoyed the video.
We just did some major mall damage. I have never tried boba before. Ooh, that was good. Happy first day of the Sephora sale, you guys. I did some major damage. If you watched my video yesterday, you know that I said I wasn't going to get that many things. And I'm not going to show you no total or anything, but we did a lot of damage, that's for sure. I obviously filmed it for you guys, but I'm literally so excited. So let me show you. I got my hands on the Refi primer finally. I don't know if this is going to be shit or it's going to be amazing, or am I just going to like the applicator? Because I feel like the hype is just because of how it rolls on. But you know me, I like to try everything. So I also bought this Ole Henriksen Banana Bright Vitamin C Under Eye Stick, and I think I'm going to love it. I like that brand a lot. I bought 1 million things from Patrick Ta. You guys, hold on. Hold on. Hold on. But so much stuff from Patrick Ta. I finally got the dual-ended. Oh, and another blush. I've never really tried much from Danessa Myricks, and I'm so excited. I got some of her color paints or something like that. They're like glitters and shimmers. Just look at these ones. Hold on. Look at this. They look absolutely stunning. I'm so excited for those. I did get the one thing I went in for, literally. They didn't have the Bobbi Brown face base in store anymore, which was really depressing, but they did have this Tarte Poreless Smoothing Timeless Primer. This stuff is OG. I haven't used it in a while, but I'm really excited about it. I did pick me up the Fenty Beauty Mascara to review it for you guys, so this better be good because I chose this over buying the It Cosmetics Superhero Mascara. That's my ride or die mascara, so let's see if this can replace it, because I love volumizing mascaras, and this is called Hella Thick, so we need Hella Thick lashes. $30 for this baby magic serum, but you know what? I had to try it. I was going to go ahead and just get the big one, but I was like, let me see if I like it and see if the hype is real. So I feel like I'm going to really like this because I have such dry skin. I picked up a Makeup by Mario sculpting contour stick. I really love these. And I picked it up this time in the shade light medium because I wanted something more cool toned versus like cream bronzers because I have a million bronzing shades, but I don't have a lot of cool tone shades for like contouring. It's my excuse for buying stuff. I was obsessed with these from back in the day. These are the Heavy Metal by Urban Decay. They're like liquid glitter shadows. So I'm really excited. I picked 3 shades up. There's literally so much more stuff in here, but I did film a haul for you guys of me picking out everything. Like, it's not even like showing right now. But yeah, what else did I get? I got some lashes, but we did good today. Bad, but good.
My Sephora package finally arrived in the mail. This is what I was most excited about. This is the House Labs blush in Watermelon Bliss. It's so vibrant. I am so excited to try this out. I've been wanting to try out Tower 28. I got their lip gloss in coconut. Okay, I can't wait to try this one, so. Okay, love. Of course, I had to try this out. It's the Huda Beauty Easy Bake in Cherry Blossom. I had to try the Pore Smooth Blur Drops from Glow Recipe. The packaging's just so cute. This is the best pencil eyeliner. It's in the shade Soft Brown. It comes with the pencil side and then also the brush side to blend it out. Okay, this is a lot smaller than I was expecting, but it's the Clear Polish Choice Oil-Free Moisturizer. I got a ton of stuff in store too. I really needed some new skincare, so I'm trying out these First Aid beauty products. This is the moisturizer for nighttime, and then this is their AHA scrub. My friend told me that this faded brightening serum is amazing for hyperpigmentation. I'm trying the Dior Forever Skin Correct Concealer. I got it in the shade 1W Warm. The packaging's just so beautiful. Lastly, was a little bit of an impulse buy, but it's the Say Beauty blush in Rosy. It's just like a nice, like corally pink color. I am planning to do a full face of the new product tomorrow.
I literally blacked out in Sephora. I have 2 big bags of stuff that I got, literally not even for me, but for you guys, because I'm doing a bunch of giveaways in December. So I thought I would show you guys everything I bought because I am so excited. I love gift giving. Gift giving is literally my love language. So I had to spoil you guys because I obviously wouldn't be in the position that I am if it wasn't for you guys. So I thought I would give back all throughout December. I'm basically Santa Claus this year, but like makeup edition. The first thing I got was this Glow Recipe Fruit Babies. This is basically a set of all their like best sellers. Then I got the Sephora Favorites Holiday Lip Kit. It has like from Charlotte Tilbury to Rare Beauty to Tarte, all the different like best sellers. I then got this Laneige lip mask set. So it comes with a bunch of different little lip masks. I swear by these every single day and night and before I do my makeup. These are amazing. Next, just in case I have some hair girlies following me, this is the Ultimate Holiday Hair Hydration Kit. We have like Pureology, Amika. Next for my perfume girlies, I got the Sol de Janeiro set. So this kit comes with all the different popular scents and they're all like mini sizes. Next, I got 2 more sets from Sol de Janeiro. This is the pink one and then this is like the original. I feel like these are so cute because they come in like these little travel pouches so you can like reuse the bag and put your makeup in. Then I got this Summer Fridays, the mini lip butter balm set. This is really cool. I love the Summer Fridays. This stuff is literally amazing so you can try out all the different flavors. I always say flavors, but I mean shades because who is eating their lip balm? Next is this glowy super gel from Say. They come with like 2 different shades, Star Glow and Warm Glow. I have the Charlotte Tilbury Superstar Glow Kit. This comes with the iconic bronzer and blush that everyone wants, but it's always sold out. So they came out with a kit of it. Finally, I had to get another thing from Charlotte Tilbury. This is the Pillow Talk set. So it comes with like the lip liner, the lipstick, the highlighter, and the lip gloss. So this is everything I got from the Sephora sale. Everything's falling.
First up is the Sol de Janeiro number 68, and this is the body spray, and I got it in the, I believe this is like an 8 ounce. I'm the girl that hates the original scent, okay? I'm sorry, I can't stand it. It is way too much for me. And I love this one because it really does remind me of my Baccarat. We got the Super Goop Glow Screen. Oh my gosh, this I've been wanting for the longest time. I've seen so many people using the niacinamide drops underneath their makeup like as a primer and everyone seems to love it, so I guess I'm the last one to try it. Tell me this isn't the prettiest lip gloss ever. Purely for aesthetic. The Jisoo, what is this, the honey infused lip oil. This was definitely influenced by TikTok. Es que me chifla a veces. two more Mario liners. One of them is a lip liner and it is in the shade Milk Chocolate, and the other one is in Soft Brown. This one's for the eyes. NARS Soft Matte in Ginger. I've already tried this like two times and it never seems to work underneath my eyes, but I want to use it around my face. The NARS Powder in Sunshore. I picked up another one of the Drunk Elephant bronzy drops and I already own it, but I was kind of low on the bronzer, so I figured I would get a backup. Now, I know that a lot of people, you either love it or hate it. Some people say that it's really streaky, but I think it's user error. You are supposed to mix it, like with a moisturizer. This is the Sephora Micro Smooth Face Palette, and it has two blushes, one highlighter, and one bronzer. The Refi Brow Tint. I already used it. I'm not sure if I love it. And last, but definitely not least, I had to get something from Rare Beauty, and I picked up the Soft Pinch Tinted Lip Oil. I love lip oils. I love lip balms. I actually prefer them over lipstick, and I chose shade Honesty. How pretty. And that is my biggest Sephora haul ever. Bye.
Huge back to school haul. Sephora, Brandy Melville, and also Garage sent me some clothes that I've been wanting for so long, and I'm so excited. And I also got something that was really hard to find at Sephora, and I can't believe I found it. I'm gonna start with Brandy. The first thing I got is a hoodie, because in my last video, I lost a bet, and I had to show up to class wearing an emo girl shirt, and it literally said emo girl. So now I'm trying to fix that and actually look like a normal person. So I got this New York hoodie, and this is gonna be perfect for school because I just want to be comfy, and it's so big, like I just love it. The second hoodie is this Malibu sweatshirt. It's also an extra large, like this is just a must-have for school. And I also got this little black tank top, just gonna come in handy. And I'm so excited to show you guys what I got at Sephora, but first let's do Garage. I've been wanting to get this for a long time and I can't believe it's here. So thank you so much, Garage. Okay, first is this Downtown New York tank top, and I kind of have a downtown girl aesthetic. I'm not sure if it's visible right now, but that's kind of the thing I'm going for. They also sent me this black top, which is really cool. This is just my vibe. Another shirt is this orange one, which I just needed some more color in my wardrobe. So this is just a cute little orange moment. Honestly, it's just adorable. Is this what I think it is? Hold on. Okay, I'm gonna show you guys. Okay, this is the white sort of like corset. Look at the lace here. I'm obsessed. I love it. And this is how it looks like clipped in. Oh, I just, okay guys, this is an oversized tee. It's also New York. As you can see, I'm like obsessed with New York. This is gonna be perfect for school. Like, I'm probably gonna wear this the next day. And then this black corset top, which is also really cool. Giving the cool girl vibes. Okay, what we've all been waiting for, Sephora. I'm gonna start with Touchland hand sanitizer. Like, just gotta have this at school. It smells so fresh. And I just needed to get this sunscreen, which is the Super Goop SPF. I gotta have this as a part of my skincare. I got the Sol de Janeiro pink cream, and they just released the pink jet set. So I just got this pink cream. The smell is beyond amazing. I wish you guys could smell it right now. Okay, I see it. Before I show you guys what I got, I actually got this Fenty Beauty contour stick, and it's like this creamy texture, which I love. Okay, I got this Summer Fridays lip balm, the pink one, the pink sugar lip balm. That's one of the most popular shades of their lip balms. Like, I'm just so excited to use it. So that's it for the haul, and I'll see you guys.
I spent $300 at the Sephora sale, so let's do a haul. To start off, I got this Pharmacy Green Clean Trio. Comes with three minis. A restock of my absolute favorite sunscreen, the Innisfree. This is my third bottle. Love it. I really wanted to try Kérastase Hair Care because I've heard it's amazing. So I got this Detangler Leave-In Conditioner for weakened hair prone to breakage. So, hope it's good. Alright, the second bag has the good stuff. The normal Sephora store that I usually go to does not sell Gucci makeup, so I went to the one at Sawgrass Mills and they have Gucci makeup there, and I just had to splurge, so I got the bronzer in 01 and the blush in 07 True Pink, and the packaging is stunning. The bronzer, when I swatched, looks so good for fair skin, and oh my god, I almost dropped it, oh my god. And yeah, this is just,
I just had to because I get 20% off, so why not? The blush packaging is so cute with the little stars, and the shade is so pretty. It's like this cool baby doll pink. I'm obsessed. Okay, Sephora Collection skincare is so underrated. Their niacinamide toner, I've gone through a whole bottle, so I had to restock, and it's 30% off. So I got the clarifying toner. This is the niacinamide and zinc. And then I also wanted to try their vitamin C and E super glow toner. Okay, I got this little duo pack because I was just grabbing things, literally grabbing things. It has candy apple and mystery glaze. Never tried these, and I was curious, so... Then I repurchased the Belief Aqua Balm. This moisturizer is so good for combo skin, and it's good for acne-prone skin too. I got a restock of the Huda Beauty Concealer and Shade Yogurt Drops. Mine was old and crusty, so I had to get a new one. I also got this Sephora Collection brush. It's the 99. It's for blush. It was 30% off, so it's really good for cream blush. I've seen people on TikTok use it, and it has like a little good angle. It's super soft, so... This is another restock. This is the Polish Choice Pore Normalizing Cleanser. This cleanser is so good. I've gone through a whole bottle. Super good for combo skin. It's not drying at all, but it helps with clearing out your pores and acne. And I'm just obsessed, so I had to rebuy it. And then lastly, I got these two Sephora eye masks. They were just online, and I was like, why not? So yeah, that's it. That's everything I got. And the sale ends on Monday, so I'll probably get more, but yeah. Bye.
Part two to my huge Sephora sale haul. A couple things from Rare Beauty. I picked up her tinted moisturizer and two of her like shadow sticks. I am forever obsessed with her packaging. These are the shades. This is in the shade Integrity, and this one is in Adventure. Finally gonna try out some things from Merit. I picked up the complexion stick because I always see Allie using this and she loves it. And I also picked up this like mini blush trio. Like, look at these shades. I think I could have gotten a lighter shade on this, but also test it out. Two things from House Labs, their concealer and their powder. I hear the concealer is super full coverage, and I love anything that claims to be blurring, so can't wait to test this out. Random product from Sol de Janeiro. This is a deodorant, and I'm obsessed with this smell. And I picked up this Kosas like baked bronzer. It's in the shade Beachy and looks so luminous.
Gorgeous, gorgeous girls always over blush. Gorgeous, gorgeous girls are always in a rush.
I went to Sephora a few times. There's so much new fun makeup that came out this month. So obviously I had to buy it all. And all of this stuff is acne safe. First are the new Makeup by Mario Soft Pop Plumping Blushes. It's a very thin cream formula. Here are the two colors. This is perfectly pink. This is Rose Crush. I have both of these on today. I love them. They're beautiful on the skin. I'll be wearing them all summer. And I got two of the new NARS Liquid Blushes. I got it in the shade Wanderlust and then Orgasm. I haven't fully tested these yet. I haven't made up my mind about this formula. It's pretty liquidy. It looks essentially like a lip gloss, and I kind of feel like it's gonna mess with my makeup, but I'll give it the benefit of the doubt. And this is the only one that isn't acne safe, and I justified this because it's Gucci. Like, look at that packaging. I'm in a cool toned blush era right now, and I saw this and I had to try it. There's the swatch of it. It looks beautiful. Stay tuned, I will tell you if I like it. Right now, it's looking pretty promising because it's a lot more pigmented than the Dior one and the Lawless ones that I have in Cool Tone Pink too. Then I got the new Natasha Denona Concealer. Also acne safe. I'm wearing it today. I'd say medium coverage. Looks beautiful though. I really like it. It may be competing with my Hourglass for my number one spot. Okay, and then I bought a $75 powder. This is from Westman Atelier. It's kind of this light pink powder. I tried it today. It is not worth $75. It doesn't do anything. It doesn't brighten. It just kind of mattifies a little bit. So I'm honestly happy that I didn't like it. And I recently learned that my beloved Lawless powder actually clogs your pores. So I picked up this new one from Amy Cole. This is a new brand at Sephora. Haven't tried it yet. I will keep you updated. I am really hoping it works because there's no other setting powders at Sephora that are acne safe. Pretty much. I also picked up the Makeup Forever HD Skin Matte Velvet Powder. I loved the liquid foundation version of this when I worked at Sephora, so I wanted to try this. I'm hoping that it's super mattifying because I'm a very oily girl. I got the Tower 28 Skin Tint and the Caliray Skin Tint. So far, I'm liking this one better. This one's a little messy, but we'll see. Also just reformulated the Dior Face and Body. Now it's acne safe. I got the wrong color though, so... I'm sad, but I ordered a new color and I'm really excited to try it. Okay, last up, the new Kosas lip gloss. I'm wearing it today with the new Tarte lip gloss. It's fine. I don't love it, but like, it's pretty. I'm out of time. Bye.
It was time. I went to Sephora
and I did some damage. I put everything into this bag, but I did not just go to Sephora. I also went to Ulta. So let's get into it. I'm so excited. I think buying makeup is my literal addiction, but I always wait a little bit to kind of just add to the fund, and then I go in and go crazy. I got the Refi primer. I heard good things about this primer, but honestly, I just love the applicator. This little thing that it has here that you could just roll it on. It just looks so satisfying, so I'm excited to try this. Next, I got the Hourglass skin tint. I've just seen so many people use this, and it looks so stunning on the skin. So I can't wait to try it out. The packaging is also so beautiful, but everything from Hourglass is usually a slay. Next, we have the Patrick Ta blush in She's Flushed. I wanted to get the She's Blushing one, I think it's called, but they didn't have it. So I was like, I don't really want to go to another Sephora right now. I'm just going to try this one. Packaging is so beautiful. And then let's see the color. Gorge. Got the Charlotte Tilbury contour wand. Listen, I've had this a few times already. I always say that there's better contour wands out there, but then I run out of it and I'm like, I kind of miss it. And I look at the pictures that I took when I was wearing it and I'm like, that is so pretty. So I got it again. This time I did get the medium deep shade though, because I usually get the light medium and I feel like it blends out pretty sheer. So I want to see if getting a darker shade will kind of make it, you know, show up a little bit more. Now this, I could not pull the trigger on like the actual full-sized one, so I got the mini. I do love my Huda Beauty powder, but I've heard such amazing things about the Givenchy, I think that's how you say it, Prism Libre powder. So I'm excited. Okay, I got the Rare Beauty eye brightener. I just feel like I needed some kind of brightening for under my eye because I typically go for concealers that match my skin a little bit more. Well, I just got this to kind of brighten underneath my concealer. Next, I got the Charlotte Tilbury Lip Cheat in the shade, I think it's Iconic Nude. I've heard good things about the lip cheats. So I don't really like Pillow Talk because it's too pink for me, but Iconic Nude looks like the perfect nude color. Okay, now I think we've gotten to the Ulta side of things, but I got the Clinique Almost Lipstick in Black Honey. I've heard people talk about for years. The girlies on YouTube, like Bethany Moda and all of those YouTubers that I used to watch, they would always rave about this. So I'm excited. Kind of want to try it now. It's supposed to be like a Your Lips But Better. And you guys know I love my Your Lips But Better. Ooh, this is cute. Oh, I think I love this. I restocked on my L'Oreal True Match Hyaluronic Tinted Serum. This is the greatest skin product of all time. I love this so much. It looks beautiful on the skin, glowy, dewy, natural, looks like your skin. You can build it up to make it look more like full coverage. It is just perfect. Next, I got the Kylie Cosmetics concealer. I've seen a lot of people use this. I'm always in the market for new concealer because just for some reason, I love concealers. Like, it's one of my favorite things to just try out. I've seen a lot of people talk about how creamy this one is. So, let's see. We've reached the final products. Guys, this I'm really excited about because I love my Dior lip oil, but it is a little bit too sticky for my liking. I love it. I wear it anyway, but it is a little bit sticky. If you know, you know. That e.l.f. came out with the dupe, of course. And I got like all of the shades they had that they weren't sold out of. So I got Honey Talks, Coral Fixation, Jam Session, and Pink Quartz. I cannot wait to try them. Tomorrow I'm going to do a get ready with me with all of these new products. And I'm gonna do a whole separate video trying out the new e.l.f. lip oils. So stay tuned for that. So that's everything that I got. I have high hopes. So let me know what you guys think about these products. Your opinions, if you think I should return any of these. Bye.
Let's be jolly, the halls with boughs of holly. let's go over everything that I bought from the Sephora sale. If you have not watched the video that I made about what not to buy during the Sephora sale, in that video I have mentioned the things that you should buy, and I'm gonna start with the ones that I said that you should buy. The majority of everything that I got is from the Sephora collection. It's even hard for me to even hold all of this together, but this is all Sephora collection items that I was able to get 30% off, even clearance items, 30% off the sale item. Really quick, let's start off first with skincare. I don't normally buy skincare from Sephora. I spoke to one of their employees and they had said that their line, the skincare line and the hair line had just came out recently. And I went online, I saw a lot of great reviews on a lot of the items. So I ended up purchasing the Balancing Toner, their Glow Peels. The Melting Cleansing Balm, I do use one from Benefit Cosmetics, but I know I'm gonna run out of that one really soon, so I wanted to have a backup. Resurfacing Mask Peel. Last but not least, in the skincare section from Sephora, I bought a skincare mask. I never have used any of their masks. I'm also not a mask girl, but I'm willing to give this a try on one of the nights that I just stay in. Still on the Sephora collection category, I bought a lot of makeup. I'm really big on eyeshadow sticks. I bought the eyeshadow sticks in shade 35. This is kind of like a nude matte. I also bought a cranberry-like eyeshadow stick. I bought a hydrating lip balm. It's always good to have these in the car. I always lose all of my lip balms, so I'm leaving this for sure in the car. Oh my gosh, these two items, I can't wait. I'm looking forward to using these. These two are also like liquid shadows. I love these so much because sometimes when you're on the go, these are just like eyeshadow pigments, but they're matte, and it's just good to just pop them up on the eye, good to go. But also, you can use this as an eyeshadow base and then add color on top of this. But these two, I got them in shade Russet and in shade Almond. And then also still in the long wearing eyeshadow, still going in the liquid shadow. Oh my god, I bought a lot of liquid shadows. This was a glitter one, and then this is in shade Power. Then I also got a Sephora lipstick. This is their lipstick in hashtag lip stories. This is number one. I'm gonna try it on. It's nude. It feels really good and really creamy, but I wanted to get this color because I feel like it will look great on any nude. Lipstick looks really pretty. Next up, I got the Sephora Favorites Lip Holiday Collection. I'm really happy about this because this originally valued $127. The holiday price tag is $45, and I was able to get 10% off of that because I'm an insider, but still 10% off is way better than anything at all, especially on holiday sets like this. It comes with 7 lip products: Pat McGrath Lipstick and Divine Rose, the Tarte Maracuja Lip Plump, this is in shade Cherry Blossom, Patrick Ta, I love this one, this is honestly super good. This is a Patrick Ta Makeup Volume, and this is in shade 2cc's. Also the Glossier Lipstick or Lip Plump in color Red Rouge. Rare Beauty Lip Gloss. I'm really excited to use this one. This is in shade Nearly Neutral. And then one of my favorite lip liners from Huda Beauty. This is in shade Warm Brown. I forgot to mention that there is also another lip liner, and that is Charlotte Tilbury. I think it's called Pillow Talk, but I have it in the other room because I used it earlier today. The next two items are limited edition items. This is one of the holiday collection items from Rare Beauty. It is 2 of their liquid blushes and 2 of their highlighters. I honestly have been a really big fan of Rare Beauty, and we don't need the full size thing. Honestly, I use their blushes every day, and there's no way I'm gonna finish the whole entire thing in a lifespan. Always happy to buy the travel size items only because even this is still a lot for me. The Rare Beauty blushes are in shade Wisdom and Virtue, and then on the liquid luminizer are in shades Transcend and Magnetize. Also moving on to a limited edition item, it is the Makeup by Mario Ethereal Eyes palette. I wanted to get this palette last year, but unfortunately it sold out, so I haven't had my chance to get my hands on this, but this is such a beautiful neutral palette to just have in general. Last but not least are just freebies that I got. My birthday was just recently, and like actually they ended up giving me 2 gift sets. This is from Way. This is all of their, I guess, like best items, hair items from Way. And then also I got the Elia, their blush, and then also their mascara. So thank you so much for giving me 2 items. I got some other freebies. I wanted to try out the Cactus Water toner. I think this is an acid lecture toner. And then I got some just little samplers. Hope that you guys like this video, and let me know if you guys want to see more of these types of videos on what I purchase online. Anything in particular.
I just got the most insane goodie bag of my life. Just casually, there's a fucking hair straightener in here. Two products from my favorite skincare brand of all time, Dr. Naomi. I actually met Dr. Naomi and I was fangirling. Oh, bit of a tricky one to open. This is fucked. Oh my fucking god. Oh my god, these are my favorite little hair turban. Like, obviously this is so incredible. I'm so grateful, but I'm like, I feel like I should be giving away some of this stuff. I think this is a lip scrub, which I really want one. Hopefully it is. Oh, here it is. I'm surprised there's not a fucking elephant in this bag. There's so much stuff. A little beauty blender. This was really cool. It's an anti-chafe stick, which I will be using all summer long. Okay, it's a secret. I don't know if I'm allowed to show you. Probably am, but it does say it's a secret. So maybe we'll keep that a secret.
I have a haul. I had such a stressful week of college last week, so I had to treat myself. So first up was Sephora. So this is the mini Merit blush set. I just took it out of the little package, so now we're gonna see what the shades look like. This is shade Beverly Hills. This is Fox. And this is shade Rouge. Then was Ulta. I think we could all take a wild guess on why I went to Ulta. The minute I saw e.l.f. was coming out with a lip oil, you know I ran. And I haven't even tried it yet. I waited to show it in the haul to even open it. This shade stood out to me the most because it just looks so cute. You already know we have to inspect it to see if it even reminds me of the Dior. All right, the wand, first of all, spot on. That is crazy. It smells just like the Dior. Next, I got pimple patches, which I never get because my skin is always clear. But since I've been stressed this week, my skin's been going through it a little. So you already know, these will be coming in clutch. Next, I just got this sharpener for my makeup pencils because mine are getting a little dull. And as most of you guys know, I like to do like a little wing with eyeshadow instead of eyeliner. So I got this. And I like it because it's just a single pan, perfect for fitting in my makeup bag. And that's all for my little haul. Bye, guys.
So I spent nearly $300 at Sephora today. I swear I black out on there. So let me show you the damage I did. Okay, I went in there not knowing what I was going to get. I was just in there and Sephora just told me what I needed. Let's take a moment for the super long receipt. Okay, first thing I got was the Fenty Beauty Match Stick. It's like the contour stick that they have. And I've never tried these and I've heard really good things about them. So I got it in the shade Amber. Okay, and then also from Fenty Beauty, I got a Gloss Balm Heat in the shade Glass Slipper Heat. It's just the clear one. I don't have any clear lip glosses, so this will be perfect. And it's plumping, and again, I don't have any, so. Okay, and then I got a lip liner from Rare Beauty in the shade Humble. It's this super pretty, like, mauve color. That's what it looks like. I think it's so cute. Okay, and the last lip product I got was the Sol de Janeiro Brazilian Kiss Lip Balm. I've been wanting to try this for so long, but I don't know why I haven't gotten it. Like, it is so cute, and this scent is actually just my favorite. It smells just like it, oh my gosh. And I like that it's really thick. Okay, next thing I got was a Benefit product. I got the Fluff Up Brow Wax. I have two brow products right now, but they're just not my favorite. So I just got this clear wax, and I've heard really good things about it, so I hope it's good. Okay, next I got a Huda Beauty, like, colored concealer. What are those called? Color correcting. And I got it in the shade Peach. I have their actual concealer, and I really like it. And I have really bad, like, dark under eyes. You can't really tell in camera, but I know this will definitely help. Okay, then I got the Summer Fridays Sheer Skin Tint. I've been really wanting to try this one, and I wasn't sure if I was shade 3 or shade 4, so I just got shade 3, and we're hoping for the best. Okay, last thing I got was the Huda Beauty Easy Bake in Pound Cake. Okay, I can't open it, but it's in the shade Pound Cake. I think I already said that. Yeah, that was all I got, and I won't be stepping foot in a Sephora in a very long time.
Okay, I mean, I think we did a little bit of damage today. I'm gonna have to do two parts. First, I'm gonna do Sephora, I'm gonna do this so fast. So I got the Patrick Ta clear gel wax with the brush. I got the Rare Beauty blush and bliss. I got the Green Glean makeup removing balm, the Laneige set, Dior lip gloss, which is like my favorite thing, Their Real mascara because I'm almost out, this which literally gets rid of my pimples over like 2 hours, and then a face wash. And I also got the Elephant bronzing drops. Next I'm gonna do Aritzia. So I got this set, the shorts, I got these Levi's baggy dad jeans. Oops. I got this, that's a set with these, this sweatshirt, and then these pants. I got these shorts, everything's just falling, like cargos. I got these pants with a sports bra. I got this black shirt for Europe. I got this, that's a set with the shorts, the cargo shorts. And then I got these white cargo a Goldie pants. Bloomingdale's. I got this a 9 bang set for just like summer. And then this Alexander Wang t-shirt thingy.
So cute.
Golden Goose. I got these, which I've already worn and I'm obsessed with. Okay, I got this men's jacket from Golden Goose. I think this is so cool. Next is Cartier. I bought this little bracelet to match my mom's. I'm obsessed. I've been wanting one of these for so long. It's so cute. Last but not least, the best thing we've bought in today. It's gonna take me a minute. Are you actually kidding me? Look at this jacket. Okay, so the sleeves unzip like this, or you can zip them and make it. Are you kidding me? Dior Slade with this jacket. I'm obsessed. If you can't tell, I'm obsessed with bomber jackets. And then I got, this is the golden one on. So cool. Hey, my boyfriend's already obsessed with it. It's adorable. And that is everything.
Hey guys, I have a Sephora haul. I went shopping with my friends and damage was definitely done. So first I got this Sol de Janeiro spray in 40. I have a lot of the other scents but not this one, so I can't wait to try this out. And then I got this hair oil from Gisu. I don't know how to say it, but I've been wanting this for over a year and I finally just got it and I'm so happy. Next, I got this Patrick Ta blush in the shade She's a Doll. This went absolutely like viral on TikTok and I was influenced. It is so pretty. Oh my god. I can't wait to try this out. Then I got this Too Faced bronzer in California Glow. I do not like the bronzer I have now and this one looks promising. This packaging is super cute. But that's what it looks like on the inside, and it says Sun Bunny. Next, I got the Laneige Glowy Balm in Berry. I have the lip sleeping mask, but not the lip balm. The last thing I got is this One Size waterproof setting spray. On my For You page, I saw the ad for this, and it looked really good, so I'm gonna try it out. But I really hope this is actually waterproof, because if it's not, it was a waste of my money. That's everything I got in this haul. Bye!